वर्ड ध्यायमाना इज एक्सप्लेन बाय टीकाकार उपनिषद भी बिकॉज ध्यायमाना थ्रू मेडिटेशन इज अनदर प्रॉब्लम वेदांत इन सो देयर प्रॉब्लम विद भक्ति एंड देयर प्रॉब्लम विद मेडिटेशन बोथ इन फैक्ट यू नो सो ध्यायमाना मींस इट्स अ मेडिटेशन दे डोंट माइंड बट नॉट एज अ मींस ऑफ नॉलेज एज अ मींस ऑफ कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ माइंड इट्स ऑल राइट सो मेडिटेशन ऑल्सो बींग अ कर्म दैट कैनॉट प्रोड्यूस नॉलेज सो एनी वे सो ध्याय देयरफॉर उपनिषद भी Pashyati. So dhyayamana means thinking, reflecting upon that. Vai shravanam mananam nidhyasanam. But all of those means also will be really effective if the mind is pure to begin with. Vishuddha sattva tatva sutam pashyate nishkalam. It is nishkalam, niravayavam. That means it is formless. That means the case na chakshusha gruhyate. Because nishkalam. Kala means avayava, means parts. Nishkala means partless. Partless means formless. Means niravishesha. So since Brahma the Self is devoid of all the visheshas, therefore, na chakshusha grukhyate, na pivacha, na nyehi devahi, na tapasa, na karmanava. Nishkalam pashyate, meaning pashyati. Dhyayamana by focusing one's attention on the Atma. But focusing attention on the Atma or meditating upon the Atma also should be done in keeping with the teaching of the scriptures. That's the idea. So what do you mean by meditating? Just because you sit for 1 hour, half hour doesn't mean meditation. Meditation means what? Directing the mind, having a proper flow of the thought. So certain vritti pravaha, a certain thought flow must be maintained in the mind, that is what we call meditation. When the focus of that or the center of that thought flow is your desired object of meditation. So when Atma is object of meditation, then a thought flow of which the focus is Atma, and that can be only through the guidance given by the Upanishads. That means that dwelling upon the Upanishad Vakyas. What it means is dwelling, listening to them, reflecting upon them, and then trying to make the meaning one's own. So that process all along must have Upanishad as the very basis. Therefore, dhyayamanah is Upanishad bhi tam pashyati. So, Upanishad bhi means Upanishad vakyaihi. So, by reflecting or dwelling upon the statements of Upanishad, one sees the Atma, sees the Self. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om
Yoyam Vijnanamayah Praneshu Eshantardaya Akashastasmin Chete सर्वस्य वशी सर्वस्य शानः सर्वस्य अधिपतिः सन साधुना कर्मणा भूया नो एवा साधुना कनीयान् एष सर्वेश्वरः एष भूताधिपतिः एष भूतपालः एष सेतुर्विधरणः एषां लोकानाम संभेदाय तमेतं वेदानुवचनेन ब्राह्मणा विविदिशन्ति yajnena danena tapasa nashakena etameva viditva munir bhavate etameva pravrajano lokamichyantah pravrajante etad dhasma vaitat purve vidvam sasprajanna kamayante kim prajaya karishyamaha yeshan noyam atmayan lokaiti te hasma putra ishanayasya vitta ishanayasya loka ishanayasya vyutthaya Athavikshacharyan charante Yahyeva putraishana savittaishana Yavittaishana salokaishana Uvehyete eshane eva bhavatah Sa eshane tinetyatma Agrahyo nahi grahyate Ashiryo nahi shiryate Asango nahi sajyate Asito navyatate Narishyate Etamu haivaite nataratayate Atah papam karavamite Atah kalyanam karavamite Uhe uhai vaisa ete tarate Nainam krita krite tapatah So having stated how This statement, Tamedam Vedan Vachanena, this Vividhishavakya is meant to show how the entire Veda has its application in Brahma Vidya. Tatkatham Tamedam Evam Bhutam Tam Aupanishadam Purusham Etam Evam Bhutam Savayesh Mahanajatma in that manner. So this Purusham, this Paramatma, Vedana Vachanena Vividishanti. So they seek to know this Paramatma, which is revealed through the Upanishads and only in the Upanishads, Vedana Vachanena, by the reciting of the Vedas. That's one meaning of the Vedasya Anuvachanam, Vedana Vachanam. So that is Anuvachanam. So Anuchyade, Guru Charanantram Pathyade, or Anucharanam, Guru Charanantram, Ucharanam Pathanam. Guru Charanam Antaram Pathanam, that is Anuvachanam. Nitya Swadhyaya Lakshana. In short, they seek to know Brahma through, they seek to create a desire to know Brahman through what we call the recital of the Vedas. Nitya Swadhyaya Lakshana, which is one of the enjoined duties of recital of the Vedas every day. Ke Vividishanti, who are those who desire to seek to know Brahmanaha? Brahmana Grahanam Upalakshanartham. So Vashyakara said, Brahmana here should mean all the three Varnas. Because Avishishtohi Adhikarhatrayanam Varnanam. Because all the members of all the three castes have an equal or same right to Brahma Vidya. So Vashyakara gave two meanings of this expression Vedana Vachanena. One, the commonly understood meaning, namely the recital of the Vedas. Other is Athava Vedanu Vachanena. So by Vedanu Vachanam, Vedaha Anuchyate. So that which is recited, that's how Vedanu Vachanam, whatever. So I guess this explanation should come because of the explanation given by Bhartru Prapancha. Because Bhartru Prapancha explains Vedanu Vachan as a Veda. However, in order to distinguish, even if you have that meaning that Vedana Vachana means Veda and not recital of Veda, then also the meaning should not be what Bhartru Prapancha has given, because he has interpreted his vakyas Vedanu Vachanena Vividishandi, Vedanu Vachanena Prakashyamanam Brahma Vividishandi. So the Brahmanas seek to know Brahman that is revealed by the Vedas. So here on the other hand, Bhashyakara has said Vedanu Vachanena, meaning by the Vedas of the nature of Karmakanda. So through Karmakanda they seek to know, meaning that Karmakanda has its application in creating the desire for knowing Brahma. Ye punaha mantra brahmana lakshanena vedanu vachanena prakashyamanam brahma atmanam vividishanti iti vyachakshate. Those explain that the sentence should explain, so vedanu vachanena vividishanti. So vedanu vachanena, then there is an adhyahara, prakashyamanam brahma vividishanti. So they seek to know Brahman that is revealed by the Vedas. Tesham aranyakamatrameya vedanu vachanam syat. So then they would restrict the meaning of the Veda to that portion which reveals Brahman, which is only Upanishad. Nahi karmakandena parhatma prakashyate tanto upanishadam iti vishesha shrutehe. So we know very well that Karmakanda does not, the subject matter of Karmakanda is not Paramatma. Because Upanishad itself says, Tantu Aupanishadam Purusham Bruhi. Please tell me about that Upanishad, that Purusha that is revealed by Upanishad. So Paramatma is the subject matter of Upanishad and not Karmakanda. As revealed by this very statement, Tantu Aupanishadam Bruhi. Vedanu vachanena iti cha avisheshatvat samastagrahidam vachanam. And therefore, it is not proper to restrict the word Veda to merely Upanishad, because And so it is not proper to restrict the meaning of the word Veda to merely one portion of the Veda, namely Upanishad. Because Veda should be, the word without restriction should include the entire Veda. Nachatat ekadeshot sarga yukta. And therefore, it is not right that we should either discard a portion of it or restrict the meaning only to one portion of it. Nanutvat pakshepi Upanishad varjanam mid ekadeshatvam syat. But when you say that Vedanu Vachanena mean Karmakandena Vividishanti, meaning thereby that Karmakanda becomes a means of Vividisha, then also you are restricting the word Veda to merely Karmakanda. So you have the same defect, same contradiction. Na Adhyavyakhyane Avirodhatvat. But now, when we interpret the word Vedanu Vachanam as recital of the Veda, then Veda means the entire Veda. If that is the meaning, that is interpretation that is accepted, then we are not restricting the meaning of the word Veda to any portion. Yada Vedanu Vachana Shabdena Nitya Swadhyaya Abhidhyate. So if why the word Vedanu Vachana is meant the daily recital of the Vedas, Tada Upanishadapi Parigrihitaeva, then the recital Upanishad also is included. Iti Vedanu Vachana Shabdartha Ekadesho Na Parityakto Bhavati. And in that case, the word Veda includes the entire Veda. We don't have to exclude anything, nor restrict the meaning of the word Veda to a certain portion. Yajnyadi Saha Pathacha. And also Vedanu Vachanam should mean recital of Veda, because Yajnyadi Saha Pathacha. The Vedanu Vachanena is read along with Yajnena, Danena, Tapasa, Anasakena. And therefore, Vedanu Vachanam should fall in the same class as Yajna, Dana, etc. Yajnadini Karmani Evanu Kramishyan Vedanu Vachana Shabdam Prayunte. So, Yajna, Dana, these are followed. So, they follow this Vedanu Vachanam. And they are the nature of karma. Therefore, Vedanu Vachanam also should be some kind of a karma. Vachikam karma here. Tasmat karma eva Vedanu Vachana Shabdena Uchyate iti Gamyate. Therefore we say that instead of the meaning of Vedanu Vachana as Veda, we should say it should mean the recital of the Veda, because it is consistent with yajna, dana, tapah, all of which are the nature of karma. So Vedana Vachanam should also be some kind of karma. In this case, vachikam karma. Karma hi nitya svadhyaya. This daily recital also is vachikam karma. Is karma performed at the oral level of the verbal level. We are on the page 1283, katham punaha nitya svadhyayadivihi karmabhi atmanam vidishanti. Naivahi tani atmanam prakashanti yatha upanishadaha. Alright. Now, when Vedanu vachane vidishanti, if you mean Vedanu vachane as recital of the Veda, if Vedanu vachane had to mean one portion of the Veda in the karmakanda, or if it had to mean Vedanu vachane prakashyamanam, then it should be all right. But Vedanu vachane katham vividishanti, how can anybody seek to know Brahman through recital of the Vedas? Nai vahitani atmanam prakashayanti. This recital does not in any way reveal Brahman because it is not karma, it is not pramanam. And only Upanishad is pramanam. Yatha Upanishad prakashayanti. Mahashakar is naishadoshah karmanam vishuddhihetutvad. Says no, that is not the problem. The point is, how can karma give rise to the desire to know Brahman? What relationship karma can have knowledge? So, naisha dosha karmanam vishuddhi hetutvat. That karma are the cause or the means of vishuddhi, antahkar shuddhi, the inner purification. Karma vihi samskritaha hi vishuddhatmanah. Shatnavandi atmanam upanishat prakashadam apratibandhena vedam. He because karma bhi samskritaha vishuddhatmanah. So those people who have become purified through karma, upanishat prakashitam atmanam apratibandhena vedam shaknuvanti, it is known that they are able to know atma that is revealed by Upanishad without any hindrance at all. Those who attain the inner purification through the karma, they are able to know atma revealed by the Upanishads without any obstacle at all. तथा चाथर्वणे विशुद्ध सत्वः ततस्ततम् पश्यते निष्कलम् ध्यायमानः ज्ञानप्रसादेन विशुद्ध सत्वः ततस्ततम् पश्यते निष्कलम् ध्यायमानः ज्ञानप्रसादेन by the favor of one's own mind. That means purification of mind. Anything that is pure is favorable. In general, to make something favorable to us, it should be pure. Our relation should be pure. Either way. So, vyavahara also, shuddhikarana vyavahara, in order to make vyavahara also favorable. Or, to make the mind favorable, the mind is made pure. So, jnana prasadena. So, that jnanam is jnayate anayanayati or anayayati jnanam. So, that by which something is known, namely buddhi. So, badi prasada, the favor of buddhi. Vishuddha sattvaha, one who has become purified in the heart, ततः सो ततः नित्यादि अनुष्ठानात् विशुद्धिः सो ततः नित्यादि अनुष्ठानात् विशुद्धिः ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ द प्यूरिफिकेशन ऑफ माइंड तं ध्यायमानः तं निष्कलं पश्यते पश्यति तं निष्कलं नोज दैट पार्टलेस फॉर्मलेस ब्रह्म ध्यायमानः उपनिषद्भिः सुहि श्रवणं मननं उपनिषद् सेवनं. So, by a study and reflection of the Upanishad, they know Brahman, that is, there is in fact devoid of any vishesha or qualifications. Unqualified Brahman, they know, as the very self. Then Bhashyakara says further, स्मृतिश्च ज्ञानमुत्पद्यते पुंसां क्षयात् पापस्य कर्मणः इत्यादि. ज्ञानमुत्पद्यते पुंसां क्षयात् पापस्य कर्मणः. papasya karmana akshayat pumsam jnanam utpadyate. So, pumsam, for the seekers, jnanam utpadyate, the knowledge occurs, takes place, papasya karmana akshayat, by akshaya, by the exhaustion of papa karma, or exhaustion of all the tendencies the papa karmas have created. The tendencies are all the passions, the various reactions that are created by having, let's say, violated the order. So that is called papa karma, where there is a deliberate violation of order, which of course happens due to papa karma only. Why should anybody violate the order to begin with? So I deliberately violate the order because there is some impulse that is stronger in me than the order. And therefore, papa karma leads to papa karma. Papa papunya vai punyena karmana bhavati, papa papena. And therefore, when papa karma samskara are there, then there is a tendency to do papa karma. And punya samskara are there is a tendency to do punya karma. But anyway, that is where the injunctions of scriptures come into play, that one is committed to following the injunctions of scriptures, and if necessary, one will subdue one's inner passions or tendencies in order to conform to the scriptures. In that way, papasya karmana kshayat, when one deliberately leads a life which is in keeping with the injunction of scriptures or guidelines of scriptures, then papakshaya has to take place. And that is the so avidya mrityam tirtva, the purpose of avidya or karma is to help this person cross the death. Now what is the death? This swabhavika, this ragadvesha. So this swabhavika, the natural tendencies of likes and dislikes, or these various reactions, are what we call the papa. And one has to subdue them in order to follow the injunction of the scriptures. And when this papa karma kshaya takes place, jnana utpadyate, then the knowledge has to arise. Knowledge arises. footnote number 4. Yatha darshatare prakhe pashyatyatmanam atma iti smriti sheshah. Yatha adarshatale prakhe, adarsha the mirror, just as the surface of the mirror is clean, then pashyati atmanam atmani, how one sees one's face very clearly when the mirror is clean, or when it is clean of all the dirt, and similarly also when the mind is made clean of all the dirt or impurities of ragadvesha, one sees oneself atmanam atmani pashyati, one sees the self in the self. That means that very mind becomes conducive to revealing the true nature of oneself. The mind then becomes free from the tendency to project. So mind, the influence of rajas, tamas, the tendency to project one's upon one's own self. So thus all the various notions or the complexes are nothing but the creation of one's own mind. So sattvic mind is that which is disposed not to project, and which is disposed to see things as they are. And that is so, that is how the knowledge takes place. So, yatha adarshatare prakhe, when the surface of the mirror is cleaned of all the dirt, how one sees one's face clearly, and so also one sees oneself clearly in the mind that is devoid of all the impurities. In short, the mind itself becomes conducive, becomes favorable to reveal the true nature of the self. Now, before we go, proceed further on the page 1283, there is a footnote here, this, a couple of words of this Vartika. Nityad anusthanaditi adena kamyam karma grihyate. Again. So, nityadi anusthanat vishuddhadihi. So, one who has become vishuddhadhi, one who has become pure in the intellect, nityad anusthanat, on account of anusthana, on account of performance of the enjoined duty. Then the footnote says, adina kamyam karma grihyate. Even the performance of kamya karma also gives rise to purification of mind, or performs those karmas which are generally thought to be kamya karma. Even performance of them also can give, because they are karma. It was already discussed and will be brought up again here.
तथा च वार्तिके संसारानर्थ हेतुत्व ज्ञानायैव च कर्मणां काम्यानि विनिर्देश तज्जिहासा प्रसिद्धो काम्य कर्म आल्सो कैन लीड टू जिज्ञास इन अ डिफरेंट वे
सो इन द थर्ड लाइन द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दिस वर्स इज दैट शुद्धि द्वारा मुक्ति फलोपायित्वात् नित्य कर्मणां उत्तम पुमर्थ अन्वय मुक्त्वा काम्यकरणां तदन्वय प्रकारमाह शुद्धि द्वारा मुक्तिफलोपायत्वात् नित्यकर्मणां सो नित्यकर्मणां शुद्धि द्वारा मुक्तिफलोपायत्वात् सो नित्यकर्म आर द मुक्तिफल उपाय नित्यकर्म बिकम द उपाय द मीन्स ऑफ गिविंग राइज टू मुक्ति और मोक्ष शुद्धि द्वारा थ्रू द प्रोसेस ऑफ प्योरिफिकेशन ऑफ माइंड कर्मणां उत्तम पुमर्थ अन्वय मुक्त्वा हाउ कर्म देन बिकम अन्वय कंड्यूसिव टू उत्तम पुमर्थ टू मोक्ष विच इज द अल्टीमेट गोल सॉल्व बाय द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स हाउ कर्म आल्सो बिकम अग्रीएबल टू और बिकम द मीन्स ऑफ मोक्ष विच कर्म नित्य कर्म हाउ द नित्य नैमित्तिक कर्म दैट आई एंजॉयड दे बिकम द मीन्स फॉर मोक्ष थ्रू बुद्धि शुद्धि दैट आई विल एक्सप्लेन दैट काम्यकर्मणां तदन्वय प्रकारमः हाउ काम्यकर्म आल्सो कैन बिकम द मीन्स ऑफ मोक्ष दैट्स व्हाट वार्तिक संसार इति संसार अनर्थ हेतुत्व ज्ञाया एव च कर्मणां काम्यानां इह निर्देशः काम्यानां कर्मणां इह निर्देशः सो इह मीन्स वेद हियर द वेदादि काम्यकर्मा आर आल्सो डिस्क्राइब्ड For what? Samsara anartha hetutva jnanaya. Merely jnanaya for the knowledge of samsara anarthatva hetu as to how they give rise to all kinds of samsara, which is anartha. The Tika explains it. Yada vede kamyani karmani uktani garvvasadi anartha hetu jnayante. So when one realizes that performs of kamya karma, or performs of any karma to fulfill a desire. So it does in fact bring about fulfillment of desire, but then in order to fulfill the desire, then one has to again take another birth. So garbhavasadi anartha hetavah. Garbhavasa itself is a big pain. And then followed by pain, a series of pains only. So there is anartha. All kinds of calamities or suffering only follows the garbhavasa, and garbhavasa is that which follows the kamya karma. सो वेदे याद वेदे काम्यानि कर्माणि उक्तानि गर्भवासाद् अनर्थयेतव ज्ञायन्ते सो ऑल द काम्य कर्म दैट आर स्टेड इन द वेदास एंड व्हाट द वेदास डू आल्सो इज दैट दे एनकरेज दिस पर्सन और मोटिवेट द पर्सन टू परफॉर्म डिजायर प्रॉम्प्टेड एक्शंस बाय हाइलाइटिंग और बाय यूलाइजाइजिंग और बाय प्रेजिंग द रिजल्ट्स दैट वन गेन्स थ्रू द काम्य कर्म It's a simple marketing technique, you know, and to entice this person. Because otherwise he won't do anything. The reason as to why a person is encouraged to perform even kamya karma is otherwise he won't do anything. That is all right. See, if you do this, this is what you will get. That's the first motivation. Then he says that now look for something better than merely this mundane ends. So when he performs kamya karma, then he is being told that look, this kamya karma give rise to only a series of birth and death, which is nothing but a series of pain. Tada teshu jihasa upavartate. Then there is a jihasa hatamicha. Then there occurs a desire to give them up. Tatascha nityadi anusthana. And when kamya karma is given up, the only anusthanam that remains is anusthanam, the performance of nitya karma. Parishuddha buddhe. And that's how one becomes person of purified heart. Vividisha dvara. And then, through the vividisha, muktihiti yukta tesha api prakriti phala anvayita ityarthah. So kamya karma in a negative way. Kamya karma by creating jihasa or vairagya, then create in a person the commitment to adopt those means which are direct means, which are means of moksha. And that is how then a person gets committed to performs of nitya karma. And that's what then nitya karma means, these actions performed without the demand of the reward, which brings about the process of purification, which creates the vividisha, the desire to know, which leads to the shastra shravanam, etc., which creates the knowledge, which ultimately leads to moksha. And that's how kamya karma also anvaya. They also are means of moksha. In a way different from how the nitya karma are the means of moksha. That's what Vartikara said, samsara anartha hetutva jnanayeva cha karmanam kamyanam ehi nirdeshah. In Veda, the kamya karmas are all mentioned in order for the people to know how they give rise to anartha of the nature of samsara. The jihasa prasiddhaye, to bring about the jihasa, the desire to give up the kamya karma. So this is Tireshamavi prakrishta phalanvayita. Prakrishta phala is moksha. So that's how kamya karma also, they also fall in line with the moksha in this manner. Then tesham vidhantarena moksha anvayitum sambandha granthoktam smarayati. Tesham vidhantarena. In another way also, kamya karma can become the indirect means of moksha. They get connected to moksha. Anvaya means that they also get connected to moksha. Sambandha granthoktam smarayati. Which had been stated in the sambandha grantha, that Vartika reminds us, yadvayati. Yadva vividishartattvam kamyanamiha karmanam tametamidi vakyena sanyogasya prathaktvatah. This verse has already been discussed earlier. Yadva vividishartattvam kamyanami karmanam yadva, or kamyanami karmanam vividishartattvam. That even kamya karma also can bring about vividisha, or they can also create the desire for knowledge. How? Tametam idi vakyena. Tametam vedana vachanena brahmanaha vividishanti yajnena danena tapasa. It doesn't say kamya or nishkama. The idea is that yajna, dana, tapaha, which are also mentioned as kamya karmas elsewhere, are mentioned here as means of vividisha. Therefore, yajna dana tapaha can become means of both svarga as well as vividisha. Sanyogatva prasaktvataha. Sanyogasya prasaktvataha. Badi sanyoga prasaktvanyaya. So, tika said, katham tani phalantaroddeshena vihitani vividishayam upayujyante katham tani. Those kamya karmas phalantaroddeshena vihitani. So kamya karma, the desire prompted actions, we are vihitani, which are enjoined for phalantara, for other phala like svarga, etc. katham tani vividishayam upayujyante. How can they be upayogi, useful in vividisha? Tatha tatra sanyogasya prasaktvatah. Ekasya tu ubhayatve sanyoga prasaktvam iti jaiminiya siddhanta sutram. So we already saw this. Sanyoga vakyam tasya prasaktvam bhedah. Ekasya ubhayartatve niyamaka iti tadartah. So ekasya tu ubhayatve, meaning ekasya ubhayartatve niyamaka. So when one dravya or one thing is mentioned in two different places, then it reveals that a thing can give rise to more than one result or one kind of a consequence. So one thing is capable of sometimes creating two different kinds of outcomes, rather, because one thing is mentioned in two separate places. So it is not that one thing can create only one outcome. depending on how it is used, it can create different outcomes also.
Yatha dadna juhyadadi phala asanyukta vakyena kratvarthena kratvarthatvena vihitasyabhi dadna. Like dadna juhyad, one should offer dadhi or curd. Idi phala asanyukta vakyena. It doesn't say that it gives rise to any result. Kratvarthatvena vihitasyabhi dadna. So thus dadhi yodhi, which is merely becomes a part of performing a certain yaga, which offering dadhi doesn't seem to give rise to a result, you know, in that particular statement. Dadna indriyakamasya juhyadidanena phalaya vidhanat. Elsewhere, dadna indriyakamasya juhyad. So one who is desirous of vigor of the sense organs, he should offer curd. Purushartha tami bhavati. So it looks like dadhi does not produce any purushartha in dadna juhuyat. But dadhi seems to produce purushartha in terms of giving vigor of the sense organs. That means it gives rise to result also. Tata jyotishtamadinam swaragadarthatvena vihitanapi. Just as one dadhi therefore can have two applications. Similarly also, jyotishtamadi yajnadan etc. swaragadarthatvena vihitanam. Even though they are generally enjoined as a means of svarga, yajnyena ityadi vishavakyena vividisha sadhanatma visyadeva iti bhava iti. But then, yajnyena dana vipasayana vividisha vakya, they are mentioned as means of vividisha. Therefore, we understand that this yajnyadi karma, even though they are mentioned in the kamya section, like jyotishtoma. So jyotishtoma adi yajnya, which are generally understood to be kamya karma, also, when they are performed without kama, then they can also give rise to the antahkarana shuddhi. This is what Bhashyakara always says, including the introduction of Gita and everywhere it is said, the same karmas which give rise to devatva, also performed without the phalabhisandhi, will give rise to antahkarana shuddhi. Okay, so that is that. Now, going to page 1284. So, Adishabdena Kashaya Pakti Ityadi Smriti Sangraha. So, Ityadi, you know. Jnana Uttpadde Pumsaham Kshayat Papasya Karmana Ityadi Smritischa. So, what are the sentences, the statements? Adishabdena Kashaya Pakti Ityadi Smriti Sangraha. Footnote number 5, there on that page 1284. Kashaya paktih karmani jnanam du paramagadehi kashaya karma vipakve tato jnanam pravartade iti samagram. Paktihi means pachanam, cooking. Kashaya paktih karmani. So karmas are meant for cooking. Cooking the kashaya, all the impurities. That means they are meant for maturing the impurities or removing the impurities. Jnanam du paramagatihi, where jnana and the knowledge is a means of paramagati. Kashaye karma bihi pakve, when the kashaya's impurities are in fact removed by karma, tato jnanam pravartate, then the jnanam takes place in the samagram. Then says Anandagiri here, Nitya Karmanam Samskarathatve Pramanam Pucchati. This Nitya Karmanam Samskarathatve, the Nitya Karma are means of samskara or purification. Where is the Pramanam? So, Kathamiti. Katham punaha nityani karmani samskarathani ityavagamyate. Katham punaha, how again? Nityani karmani. this nitya karmas, all the daily enjoined duties, samskara arthani, that they become the earth, they become the means of samskara purification, katham avagamyate. So how do we learn this? How do we understand that the nitya namini karmas are meant for purification? Siddhanandagiri, yadyapi shruti smritibhyam karma bhi samskrutasya upanishad bhi atma jnanam shakyate tathapi tesham samskarathatve kim pramanamiti prashne shruti smriti pramanayati. I don't know how this question arose, that's what Anandagiri, yadyapi shruti smritibhyam karma bhi samskrutasya. Already Vashyakara himself quoted the vakyas. Vishuddha sattvastu tadastu pashyate nishkalam dhyayamanah jnanam utpadyate pumsam kshayat papasya karmanah and so forth. So yadyapi shruti smritibhyam. So even though this, from the statement of shruti in the smriti, karma bihi samskrutasya upanishad bihi atma jnatum shakyate, that atma can be known by the one who has gained the purification of the heart. The atma can be known through the Upanishad. Iti jnatum shakyate, from the shruti and the smriti, we learn that one is able to gain the knowledge of the atma from Upanishad when one has gained the antahkarana shuddhi. Tathap, even then, tesham samskarathatve kim pramanam. Still, what is the means of knowledge, or what are the statements which directly say that these nitya karmas give rise to antahkarana shuddhi? Iti prashne shruti smriti pramanayati. When this question arises, then Bhashyakara gives the statement of shruti and the smriti as pramanam, as a means of knowledge. Before that, there is a footnote number 6. Shruti smriti bhyamidyatra vihitaihi iti visheshendi guru padaha vayam tu shakyate iti anantaram iti avagatam iti shesham abhyarham mannahe. So then, here yadyapi shruti smriti bhyam iti atra vihitaihi karma bhihi. So shruti smriti bhyam jnatum shakyate. So shruti smriti bhyam karma bhihi samskrutasya. So shruti smriti bhyam is what? In the fifth case, Shruti smriti bhyam jnatum shakyate, that we learn from shruti and the smriti that the one of pure intellect gains the knowledge of atma through Upanishad. But guru pada, shruti smriti bhyam vihitahi karma bhihi. Then that becomes the third case. Shruti smriti bhyam vihitahi karma bhihi samskrutasya Upanishad bhihi atma jnatum shakyate. This is how it is sheshen the guru pada. So our gurus say, now, whoever's sticker remark is this, so they say that our teachers say that we should say in this Vakya of Anandagiri, Shruti Smriti Bhyam Vihitahi Karma Vihi. So by the karmas enjoined by the Shruti and the Smriti, then through Intahakana Shuddhi, one gains the knowledge of the Upanishad. This is how our gurus say. Vayantu Shakyade Iti Anantaram Iti Avagatam Iti Shesham Abhyarham Manmahe. However, we feel that we should add not this vihitahi, but then shakyate iti anantaram. So, jnatum shakyate, thereafter we should add iti avagatam, iti shesham abhyarham manmahe. We feel that shesha is better. Atma jnatum shakyate iti avagatam. From the statement of Shruti and Smriti, it is learned or we understand that atma can be known when one has gained the antahkarana shuddhi. So that's what Shruti and Smriti say, that when one has gained antahkarana shuddhi, then atma can be known. So we think that this statement should better be explained that way rather than the other way. Thus, from Shruti and Smriti we learn that atma can be known by the one who has gained antahkarana shuddhi. Tathapi, even then, tesham samskarathatve. So, Shruti and Smriti say that one can know Atma when one has gained the Antahakana Shuddhi through karma. Still, that the karmas bring about the inner purification, kim pramanam,
for understanding that what is the direct statement from the Upanishad. Iti prashne when that, or Shruti and Shruti, iti prashne when that question arises, Shruti Smriti Pramanayati Bhashyakara present this statement of Shruti and Shruti as Pramanam to say how Nitya Naimdi Karmas bring about Antahakana Shuddhi. So then what do we do with that? The earlier statements said that the knowledge can arise only when the Antahakana Shuddhi is there. Now the statements are that the Antahakana Shuddhi arises due to Nitya Naimiti Karma. That's the difference here. Sahava Ityadena, Bhashyakara says, Sahava Atmayaji Yo Veda Idam Me Anena Angam Samskriyate Idam Me Anena Angam Upadhiyate Ityadi Shrutehe. So Manusmriti likes to use this word Atmayaji. So one who is performing yaga for Atma, or a yaga of the nature of Atma, Atmayaji. This one is performing the Atmayaga. Sahava Atmayaji. So he is called Atmayaji, meaning that one who is performing the yaga of the Atma, Yo Veda, one knows. Idam me anenangam samskriyate. Anena idam me angam samskriyate. This anga, that is this antahkarana, becomes purified by anena, by this karma. Idam me angam anena upadhiyate. That by this karma, my antahkarana upadhiyate. So punyena upachiyate. Becomes in fact endowed with greater virtue. It's footnote 1 explains. Sahavayati. Anena karmana. Meyangam antahkaranam samskriyate. So one knows that by performance of nitya karma that my antahkarana becomes purified, he knows, so he is performing the atmayaga. Upadhiyate. So anena karmana me antahkaranam upadhiyate punyena upachiyate. Because by performing this karma, in fact my antahkarana becomes endowed with the increase in punya. And thereby it becomes purified. Iti viditva yaha karmacharati saha atmasuddhyartham yajan atmayaji. So one understanding this, iti viditva yaha karmacharati. So knowing that this karma will bring about the purification of my mind, this karma will bring about an increase in the punya or the virtue, understanding that when a person performs the karma, Saha Atma Suddhyartham Yajana. Then whatever yaga he performs Atma Suddhi or inner purification, the purification of mind, such as Saha Atmayaji. He is the one who is worshipping Atma. Such as Devayajinaha Kamyakartuhu Shreyanati Suttyarthaha. There is a, see, through Yajna, whether you are worshipping Devata or through Yajna, whether you are worshipping Atma. So even though he may be performing yajna where a devata is worshipped, but if his understanding is that through this karma my mind gets purified, then he is in fact worshipping Atma. So merely worshipper of devata is the one who worships devatas to gain a certain reward from the devatas. Whereas Atmayaj is the one who appears to worship devatas, but then he doesn't want any reward from the devatas, that is called Nishkama Karma, which brings about the purification of the mind. Such a devayajinaha kamyakartuhu shreyan. He is better, he is superior or better than the one who is devayaji, who is a kamyakarta. So one who performs the kamyakarma to appease the devatas, better than it is this person who performs the karma to appease the self. How to appease the self? By doing that which is conducive to the self. And what is conducive to the self? When you perform an action which is done in the spirit of offering, then the self is pleased. When you perform a person to fulfill a desire, then Devata is pleased. So Devata is pleased when I perform a karma or action to satisfy my desire, because Devata gets his share. Whereas when I perform a karma to purify the mind, then Atma is pleased, because Atma gets nourished. So what it is that we are nourishing? Are we nourishing the self, or we are nourishing the Devatas and other forces? This anename angam samskriyate, this is called Shruti. Shruti means a direct statement when it said that anena karmana me angam antahkaranam samskriyate, that my antahkarana becomes purified by this karma. So there, anena is the third case. Samskriyate is a result. So that karma becomes a means of samskara is very clearly stated in the Shruti here. Then says Anandagiri, Kim Punaha Smriti Shastram. Alright. This Shruti and Smriti. So what is the Smriti Shastra? Tadaha. Ashta Chattvarimsha Diti. And Vashyakara says further. Sarveshu cha Smriti Shastreshu Karmani Samskarathani Eva Achakshate Ashta Chattvarimshat Samskara Ityadishu. Sarveshu cha Smriti Shastreshu. Everywhere in the Smriti Shastra, Karmani Samskarathani Eva. That in all the Shrutis, Smriti is said that all the karmas are meant for samskara, for implanting the impression. Samskara means really an impression. So therefore all the karmas are called samskara, because they are all meant to implant impression. You are a brahmachari, you are a grihastha, you are this, you are that. And thereby creating a self-consciousness in the person. Hey, wait a minute, I'm brahmachari now. Oh, I'm father, I'm mother, husband, wife, whatever. So thus this fellow is made self-conscious. And that way made to live, or made to conduct himself in keeping with his dignity of self-consciousness. I can't do this, I can't do that. No, I am now, you're not a little boy now, you're a grown-up person, you can't do that. Yes, I cannot do that. As a child, I used to do whatever it is. But now, as a grown-up person, I cannot do. So that is what is called samskara. To create an impression in the mind. And that's the reason why the rituals would go on for a great length of time. So that this fellow, for number of days and number of hours, knows this is upanayana, upanayana, upanayana. And so, that is how brahmachari, brahmachari, brahmachari becomes implanted in his mind. Grihastha, husband, ceremony go for 3 days, 7 days, and therefore he can never forget that I have taken these vows, you know, I have taken the vows in the presence of fire, and he can never forget that. Otherwise, half an hour package, 45 minute package, you know, it's like one of those things, he can forget. This thing doesn't really create an impression in him. That something very significant has happened to me, that impression is not created in this fellow's mind. Because the wedding took place in half an hour, 45 minutes. And those fellows who finish the wedding in 45 minutes, they spend half a day in their party. That's interesting. So, they don't compromise as far as the dance and the dinner and things are concerned. There is no compromise there at all. And every preparation, every step, you know, they plan out every step. When this person comes, who will receive him, who will escort him, where he will be made to sit, who will come and offer him what kind of a drink, and everything is all planned out. When somebody comes, then all of a sudden we realize, hey, this fellow has come now, what to do? Come on, you. That's how, without, there is no planning, and therefore a crisis is created all the time. Anyway, we somehow find solution. And the fellow also expects to be treated in a certain way. He also understands. That's all right. And so that every step is planned. Even Indians also, who live in United States and Western countries, they act in the same way. They plan every step. So, Swamiji comes, Swami Vidhitatmananda comes, okay, somebody comes forward, escorts him to death. Swami Dayanandaji comes, somebody else comes. Then the groom's father comes, and then this person comes. Whoever is coming also is known. And generally when they come also is known, and that's everything is planned. All of this is elaborate. And then afterwards, different kinds of meals are there, you know, because somebody eats meat and somebody does not eat, and then the Swamis don't even eat onions and things of that sort. So different kinds of things are there. And so when you should offer what, everything is done. And afterwards there's cocktail hour and so forth, and then there is dance, and then dance also, then the people come and they give speeches, and then dance is there, and then drink is there, and dinner is there, and goes on until midnight. So this function that began at 6 o'clock goes on. So the part of the wedding was from 6 to 6:45. And then everything else. So therefore, what will he'll remember? Dance and dinner. He won't remember this thing that took place before that, you know, perhaps. Here on the other hand, dinner is okay. But the ceremony goes on and on and on, you know, from it starts so many days before and it goes on. So that is how the idea is implanted in the mind, that he will not be allowed to forget. They are all samskaras. So ashtachatvarimshat samskara ityadishu samskarathani eva karmani achakshate. Everywhere in the Smriti Granthas also, it is very clearly said that all the various karmas I perform are meant to create samskaras, are meant to implant impressions on the minds of the people. Footnote number 2. Ashta chatvarim shaditi. These 48 different things are there. 48 samskaras. Anandagiri also has to say that ashtau anayasadeha gunaha chatvarimshat garbhadhanadeha samskara iti vibhagaha. Ashtau anayasadeha gunaha. 8 are so-called anayasa. So, they are gunas. Chatvarimshat garbhadhanadeha samskara. And 40 are the samskaras beginning from garbhadhanam iti vibhagaha. So, further detail is given here in the footnote number 2. Ashtau chatvarimshati tatra anayasah. The 8 ashtau anayasadeha anasuya daya shaucham mangalyam akarpanyam aspruha anteshtihi iti ashtau atmagunaha anayasadeha. Atmagunaha, these are the gunas of the attributes of the self. Anasuya, that means non-caviling. Daya, that means kindness, compassion, shaucham, purity, mangalyam, also auspiciousness, akarpanyam. So karpanya means miserliness, non-miserliness, that is generosity. Aspruha, aspruha means desire, aspruha, desirelessness. Anteshtihi, whatever that means, anteshtihi. Anteshti means the last rites, you know. But I don't know what it means here. Atma gunaha, they say. Yastav atma gunaha anayasadeha. This. Then, hutam, huh? What is it? Anayas means without any ayasa. Ayasa means exertion. Anayasa, where there is no, but this is a technical word anyway. But atma guna, since they are the nature of the atma, therefore no effort is required to have them. In that sense, they are called anayasaha. They don't require ayasa. Other samskaras are going to require an effort, like hutam, prahutam, ahutam. So performing samskara is going to involve an ayasa effort, I guess. These things do not require ayasa, therefore they are called anayasaha, whatever. Anayasa daya. So anayasa is one. Then anasuya, daya, shaucham, all of these, you know. Anayasa one, anasuya two, daya, shaucham, mangalyam, akarpanyam, aspruha, anteshtihi. Iti ashtau, beginning from anayasa. So anayasa is whatever that means anyway. So beginning with anayasa, there are eight. Then hutam, prahutam, I thought these are called, but no, anayasa, deha, beginning from anayasa. Then hutam, prahutam, ahutam, shulam, whatever, these are all names anyway for us, there are 40 of them. You can read the names, hutam, prahutam, ahutam, shula gavaha, baliharanam, pratyavrohanam, ashtakahomaha iti, sapta, pakayajna. So these are eight are atma gunas, supposed to be the nature of the atma, nature of one's own self, that is. So all the values that one should, I guess, follow. Then hutam, prahutam, ahutam, shulagavaha, baliharanam, pratyavrohanam, ashtakahomaha iti, sapta pakayajna. So this seven pakayajna. Different kinds of, I don't know, cooking is involved, I don't know. Agnyadhanam, agnihotram, darshapurnamasu, chaturmasyani, agraneshtihi, nirudh pasubandha, sautramanihiti, sapta haviryajna. So atmagunaha, sapta pakayajna, sapta haviryajna, the yajnas in which you have to offer havi. So agnihotra, agnyadhanam, that is the piling of the fire. Agnihotram, darshapurnamasa, is the ceremony that should be performed on the new moon day and the full moon day. Chaturmasyani, and then the rituals that you are supposed to perform when a chaturmasa begins. Agraneshtihi, I think agrane is when the new crop comes, you know, then you are supposed to perform, make certain offerings. Ashtakahomaha, or nirudh pasubandha, whatever that is, and sautramanihi, so nirudh pasubandha also is some kind of a homa, and sautramanihiti, sapta haviryajna. Then, agnishtomaha, vajapeha, ukthaha, shodashi, atiratraha, aptoryamaha, iti, sapta somayajna samstaha. All the variety of somayajna. Agnishtomaha, vajapeha, ukthaha, shodashi, atiratraha, aptoryamaha, iti, sapta somayajna samstaha. So agnishtomanantaram atyagnishtomo drashtavyaha. Agnishtomaha, then atyagnishtomaha. Vajpeha, uktaha, shodashi, atiratraha, and aptoryama. Then only seven are there. Another mention are six, but then if you add one, atyagnishtomaha, then it is seven saptas. Somayagni samstaham. Okay, then garbha, then this real samskaras are this. Garbhadhanam, umsavanam, simantaha. Beginning from garbhadhanam, umsavanam, conception, simantaha, and before the simantaha, when the, I guess the child some srimanta is, No, before the birth, but they fix certain time, 6 months or something like that. Some kind of maturity happens, I think. Vishnu balihi, jata karma, Vishnu balihi, that is, I don't know. Jata karma is the karma that you perform when child is born to remove the impurities because, purification. It's a purificatory rite. Namakaranam, giving the name. Upanishkramanam, I don't know, when he goes out. Annaprasanam, feeding him first time. Karanavedaha, what do you call it? The piercing, the nose, piercing the ear lobe, I guess. Chaulam, that is the chaula karma, is the shaving of the head. Aksharasvikaranam, aksharabhyasaha. Upanayanam, Yajnapavita. Vratam, I guess when Brahmacharya Vratam, I guess when he goes to Gurukulam. Samavartanam, returning home after graduation. Vivaha, then wedding. Upakarma, I don't know. Utsarjanam, Vanaprastham, Sanyasaiti, Ekonavimshatihi, Itare. These are the 19 samskaras that we are familiar with. 16 samskaras are well known, but these are all 19 here, okay. So, sarveshu cha smriti shastreshu karmani samskarartani eva achakshate ashta chatvarimsa samskara ityadishu. They're all samskara, they're meant for samskarartha. They're all karma, they're meant for samskara. Karma are not meant to produce an result, they're all meant to produce samskara. This is what? So, all these karma are called samskaras. That shows that the purpose of karma is to bring about the purification. Then, bahuvachanopattam smrityantramaha sarveshu smriti shastreshu. So, plural is used. And therefore, Bhashyakar also says, so, bahuvachanopattam smrityantram. So, how come Bhashyakar is a plural? Because some other statements were in mind and they are being stated. Now, Gita Asuchaivi. Because at least there must be three. Plural means there must be at least three statements. So, Ashta Chatvarimsa Samskara is one statement. Then two more statements were given to justify the use of plural. Gita Sucha Yajnu Danam Tapascheva Pavanani Manishinam Sarve Pyete Yajna Vidaha Yajna Kshapita Kalmashaha Iti. Yajna, danam, tapasseva, pavanani, manishinam. Yajna, danam, tapasseva, they are manishinam, pavanani. So they bring about purification in the people. Sarve pyete yajna vidaha, yajna kshapita kalmashaha, yajna vidaha. All these people who perform these yagas, yajna, in the fourth chapter of the Gita, yajna kshapita kalmashaha, they become the people whose kalmasha, the papas, are removed by through the performance of the yajna. So these are the statements which very clearly state how the karmas are means of the purification of mind. Pavanani manishanam, yajna kshapita kalmashaha. So direct statements are there where yajna are stated as means of purification. Now before we go, we just brought here some commentary from Madhusudan Saraswati in the beginning of 5th chapter of the Gita, where he takes up this very same discussion. This is in the introduction to the 5th chapter of the Gita. When Arjuna asks this question, sannyasam karmanam krishna tatha yogam tishamsasi. So, on one hand the karma sannyasa, on the other hand the karma yoga. Yachre etavarekam tanme bruhi sunishitam. Whatever is the better of the two, please tell me. So, what kind of sannyasa is this? This is the question. When Arjuna is asking about sannyasa, what kind of sannyasa is this? Is it the vidvat sannyasa? Or is it the Vividisha Sannyasa? So therefore, from the question of the Arjuna and from the nature of karma and sannyasa, they determine that this is a question about Vividisha Sannyasa. Because Arjuna has a choice. Either take Vividisha Sannyasa, that is, renounce the karma and pursue the knowledge, or perform the karma in the spirit of yoga. Then a question can arise. And that means that the karma and the jnana also, there cannot be samuchya of the jnana karma. That's the point also they want to make. That this is not the question about vidvat sannyasa or paramarthika sannyasa, because what that is already determined. Karma yoga also, this cannot be questioned because that also is understood. Therefore, this is the question pertaining to vividisha sannyasa. Tathacha jnaninaha karma anadhikare nishchite. That jnani or the wise person does not have adhikara for karma. Because karma is already done, what needs to be done. Therefore, jnani now has no adhikara, in fact no fitness to perform any karma.
because there is no kartrutva buddhi.
Prarabdha karavasat vritha cheshta rupena tad anusthanam va.
So either he can keep on performing karma as a vritha cheshta, because prarabdha karma keeps his body alive, therefore he continues to live without any kartrutva buddhi.
Sarva karma sanyaso vayati.
So he can perform the karma also, a jnani, or sarva karma sanyasa, he can give up all the activity also.
It is nirvivadam chaturthe nirinitam. So karmanyabhi pravrttopi naivakinjit karoti sah, yadruchalava santushta dvandvajdo vimatsaraha samasiddhava siddhavja krutvabina nibadhyate.
So one was a description of a jnani who is active, another was a description of jnani who is retired or who is resigned.
Therefore, what is vidvat sannyasa is already determined. Agnena tu antahkana suddhi dvara jnanotpatte karamani anusthayani.
However, for an ignorant person, agnena tu antahkana suddhi dvara
sugnanotpatte,
in order that the knowledge takes place through the step of antahkana suddhi,
karamani anusthayani,
an ignorant person must continue to perform the karma.
Tametam vedanu vachanena brahmanah vividishanti yajnena danena tapasanashakeniti shrutehe.
The shruti says, therefore, ignorant person must perform the karma for antahkana suddhi.
Sarvam karma akhilam partha jnane parisamapedit bhagavad vachanach.
In the fourth chapter, Lord Krishna said, then all the karma culminates into knowledge, meaning karma is the means of knowledge.
Evam sarvani karmani jnanarthani.
Therefore, all the karmas are meant to serve the purpose of jnanam. They should become a means of knowledge.
Tatha sarva karma sannyasobhi jnanartha shruyate.
So just as all the karmas are means of knowledge through antahkarana shuddhi, so also we find that karma sannyasa also is a means of knowledge.
How? Etameva pravrajana loka vichyantaha pravrajanti.
Etameva pravrajana loka vichyantaha pravrajanti.
Etameva loka vichyantaha pravrajana pravrajanti.
So desiring atma loka, the renunciates, they renounce. So that way, in this here we find that the karma also is stated as a means of knowledge, and the karma, renunciation of karma also is stated as a means of knowledge.
Tatha sarva karma sannyasobhi jnanartha shruyate. Etameva pravrajana loka vichyantaha pravrajanti shanto danto uparatastya dikshuhu samaheto bhutva atmaneva atmanam pashyet.
So shantaha, dantaha, uparataha, all of this is, as we'll explain, all of these are renunciation of karma. So one means nitya karma, renunciation of nitya karma, other is renunciation of kamya karma, etc. But ultimately this vakya also is interpreted as nothing but karma sannyasa.
Atmaneva, dantam is dhamma,
means discipline of sense organs. Shanta is discipline of the mind.
Comes to the same root, dham.
So how one, atmaneva atmanam pashyet, how one is able to see the self in one's own mind by renunciation of all the karma.
Tyajataiva hitajnyayam chaktuh pratyak parampadam.
Chaktuhu parampadam. So pratyak parampadam. So that which is the parampadam, that which is the ultimate nature of the renouncer, must be known through renunciation.
Jajataiva,
only by the renouncer can the ultimate nature of the renouncer can be known. Through renunciation, the renouncer can know his own self.
That means renunciation is a means of knowing the self.
Jajataiva hitajnyayam chaktuhu pratyak parampadam.
So that which is the parampadam of the chakta, the renouncer, can be known through renunciation only. Satyan hrude sukha dukhe vedan imam lokam amum cha parityajya atmanam anvichchet ityadav.
Atmanam anvichchet, one should commit oneself to the investigation of the self. That means the study and contemplation of the self.
Satyan hrude tyaktva yuv satyan anruta
sukha dukha Vedan, Imam Lokam, this world, Amum Lokam, that world, giving up all of this concern, one should commit oneself to the investigation of the nature of the self. Ityāda. So idea is that both the performs of karma and the karma tyaga, both of these are presented by the Shruti, the various statements and the Smriti as means of knowledge. So what should we do?
Tatra karma tatyagayoho arada upakaraka sannipatti upakaragayoho prayaj avaghatayoho iva na samuchya sambhavati.
But can we do both of them? If both of these are stated as means of knowledge, can we not combine them both? He says, no,
karma tatyagayoho.
You cannot combine the performance of action and renunciation of action. They cannot be combined because they are mutually exclusive.
Arad upakaraka sannipatti upakaragayoho.
Both of them upakaraka. Both of them are definitely helpful to knowledge. But one is arad upakarakam, other is sannipatti upakaragam. Karma is the upakaraka. Karma is a means of knowledge indirectly. Sannipatya, whereas karma sannyasa is the means of knowledge directly.
Prayaja avaghatayoho iva.
Just as prayaja is directly helpful to the performance of yaga, avaghata, pounding of the rice, is indirectly helpful to performance of yaga. Because rice is one of the dravyas. And pounding the rice is of course required, but it's not a direct, it doesn't directly contribute to the performance of yaga. So indirect and direct.
Na samuchya sambhavati.
So these two cannot be combined. Viruddhatvena yogapadya abhavat. Because they cannot happen right away, because both of them are mutually exclusive.
Nabi.
So samuchya is not possible, vikalpa also is not possible. Can we combine the two, karma and karma tyaga? You cannot. Can we have a choice, either this or that?
Nabi karma tatyagayoho atmajnana matra falatvena.
See, both of them give rise to the same result, atmajnanam. So maybe you can have a choice that either karma or karma tyaga.
Ekartatvat atiryatrarthayoho shodashigrahan agrahanayo vikalpasyat.
Can you, so when you perform the shodashi, just be, you know, one of the somayaga.
No, atiratra.
In atiratra yaga, where a shodashi grahanam is there, or shodashi agrahanam is there, the vikalpa is given. Because ultimate result is the same. Here also, ultimate result being moksha, do we have the vikalpa, the choice, that either we perform the karma or we renounce the karma? Says no.
Dwar bhedene ekartatva abhavat.
Because their dwar bheda is there. They give rise to knowledge in different ways. How?
Karmanohi papakshayarupam adrishtameva dwaram.
So karma does give rise to moksha, but indirectly through papakshaya, through the exhaustion of papa or impurities.
Sanyasasya tu sarvikshebhavena vichara avasaradana rupam drishtameva dwaram.
Whereas sannyasa, what karma sannyasa does is, because one is now free from all the responsibilities of duties, therefore all the vikshepa has gone away. And therefore,
vikshepa abhavena vichara avasara dana rupam.
So when the mind is free from all the demands and all the engagements, then there is avasara, then there is occasion of vichara, then one can have the time or the leisure to contemplate upon the self. So drishtameva dwaram. Karma is the gateway to knowledge indirectly, where sannyasa is the gateway to knowledge directly. So much closer.
So forth, all right. Tasmat kramena ubhayam api anushthayam.
Therefore, both are required. Kramena ubhayam api anushthayam. Both must be in fact taken up kramena, one after the other. But which one follows what?
Tatravi sannyasanantaram karmanusthanam chet.
Then, but it can be other way around. They do karma tyag sannyasa is there, and then karmanusthanam cannot be. That sequence cannot be.
Tada parityakta purvashma svikarena arudapati tattvat. karma adhikaritvam praktana sannyasa vayarcham cha tasya adrushtarthatva abhavad. So already you are taking up karma that you already renounced, and so aruda patitattva, you climbed and you fell down. Karma adhikaritvam praktana sannyasa vayarcham, the sannyasa that you took earlier is vyartha, and you also not adhikari for karma. So this, it cannot be that karma is followed, so follows sannyasa. It cannot be that way. Prathamakrut sannyasa neva jnana adhikara labhet tad uttarakale karma prasthana vayartham cha. And when sannyasa is there, when you already adhikari for jnanam, what's the need of taking the karma later on? Tasmad adau bhagavat arpana buddhya nishkama karma anusthanat. Therefore, to begin with, one performs the karma, bhagavat arpana buddhya, with the bhavana of the spirit of offering it to the Lord. Nishkama karma anusthanat. So performing selfless action in the spirit of offering to the Lord. Antahkana shuddhau. And it is the selflessness and the spirit of offering that brings about the antahkana shuddhi, the inner purification, when that takes place. Tivrena vairagyena vividishayam drudhayam. So some vividishaya, some desire to know was there. But as the vairagya has become very strong now, that vividishaya, the desire to know also becomes very strong, very firm. Vividishayam drudhayam sarva karma sannyasa. Then all the actions are renounced. Shravana mananadi rupa vedanta vakya vicharaya kartavyaheti. The sarva karma sannyasa kartavya. Then one should actually renounce all the actions. If antahkarana shuddhi has taken place, then one should renounce all the actions. So that vedanta shastra shravana manana, that vichara. So vichara means shravanam mananam. Basically shravana is a vichara. And manana is the asana also. Help that vichara of shravana. Sarva karma sannyasa kartavedi bhagavatah matam. Looks like this is the mata of Bhagavan. Bhagavan may not have used the word sarva karma sannyasa and vividisha sannyasa and may not have stated the krama properly or clearly, let us say. But from what Lord Krishna has said, this is what we can derive. That first antahkarana shuddhi, then the shastra vichara, then the jnanam, and then moksha. Tathacha uktam, and Lord Krishna has said, na karmanam anarambhat naishkarmyam purushosnudeiti. One cannot attain naishkarmya or moksha by giving up the dropping of the karma or dropping out of the duties. One cannot attain moksha. Vakshadecha, in the sixth chapter we stated, arurukshor munair yogam karma karanamachyade yoga rudhasya tasyeva shamah karanamachyade. So for the one who is desirous of climbing or mounting the yoga, the horse of yoga, for him the karma yoga is a means. And one who has already gained that maturity of being able to do the dhyanam, for that person the karma sannyasa is a means. So karma becomes a means of giving the qualification of performing the dhyanam. And then when that qualification or that fitness is attained, that one can be with oneself, one can contemplate upon oneself, one is free from the need, you know, of whatever, all emotional needs, then karma sannyasa is. So as long as emotional needs are there, so long dhyanam is very difficult. When one has become free from those, then there is a leisure for this person to be able to dwell upon whatever one wants to dwell, in this case Atma.
Yoga arunasita seva samah karana machyave yogatra tivra vairagya purvika vividisha.
Yoga arudha means what? Vividisha arudha. So when tivra vividisha, strong desire for the knowledge occurs, then one knows that the karma has served the purpose.
Taduktam vartikarai se pratyek vividisha siddhyai vedanu vachanadeha brahma. In fact, in reference to this vakya itself, brahma avaptayadu tatyagam abhipsanti Abhipsanditi Shruter Balat. Pratyek Vividishasiddhye Vedanu Vachanade. So Vedanu Vachanena, Yajnena, Danena, Tapasana, Shakena, all of these are pratyek vividisha siddhi for attaining or accomplishing the desire to know the Self. Brahma avaptetu. However, vividisha having been created, strong vairagya and the strong vividisha having been created, Brahma avapte for gaining Brahma, tatyagam ipsanti. The tyaga of Vedana Vachanade is what the Shruti seems to say by saying, etameva pravrajino lokamichanda pravrajanti. So when vividisha has taken place, pravrajanti, then they take to life of renunciation. It is Shrutehe Balat. So from the Shruti Bala, Arthapatti, we say that Shruti could not have stated the way it has stated had it not been the case that when Vividisha has taken place, then the karma must be given, because the Vakya of Karma Tyaga follows right away. Iti. Then, Smrutischa, this Smriti, Kashaya Pattih Karmani, Jnanam Du Paramagatihi, Kashaya Karma Vishpakve, Tato Jnanam Pravartate. Smriti also says, Kashaya Pattih Karmani, the karmas are meant for removal of impurities. Jnanam tu paramagatihi. Jnanam is the ultimate goal. Kashaye karma bhi pakve. When the impurities are removed by the karma, tato jnanam pravartate, then the knowledge takes place. Iti. Moksha dharmecha in Mahabharata. Kashayam pachaitvacha srenisthaneshu tatrishu. Trishu srenisthaneshu kashayam pachaitva. In the first three ashramas, brahmacharya, grihastha, vanaprastha, kashayam pachaitva, so leading the life properly of brahmacharya, grihastha, vanaprastha, one is able to remove those impurities. That's the purpose of these ashramas. Pravrajecha paramsthanam parivrajyam anuttamam. Then when kashaya pakti, meaning when the removal of the impurities has taken place, then pravrajecha paramsthanam, then paramsthanam, anuttamam parivrajyam pravraje, then one should take to life of renunciation, one should take to sannyasa. Bhavitaihi karanaishayam, this is in moksha dharma. This verse will be quoted by Vartikar also. Bhavitaihi karanaishayam bahu samsara yonishu asadaiti shuddhatma moksham vai prathamashrame. How it is possible that somebody may not have to go through all the three ashramas? Bhavitaihi karanaihi cha. I am bahu samsara yonishu. In the many past births, having led a virtuous life, it is possible that one may have the bhavitehi karanahi. So one's karana, this antahakarana, must be already purified in course of a number of births in the past. Then asadaiti shuddhatma moksham vai prathamashrame. It is possible that in the prathamashrama, in brahmacharya ashram itself, moksham asaya, one can gain shuddhatma. So having been born as a person of pure heart, in brahmacharya ashram itself, one can attain moksham. There moksha is of course vairagya, that's what it says later. Moksham vairagya. So one can gain vairagya in the prathamashrama, brahmacharya ashram itself, and from that itself, one can take to sannyasa.
Tamasadhyatu muktasya drishta arthasya vipaschitaha trishvashrameshu konvartaha bhavet pramabhipsitaha. Tamasadhya, having gained the vairagya and having gained the mukti, drishta arthasya vipaschitaha, mukti is a drishta, immediate result. So for this wise person who has gained the moksha, which is immediate result or evident result, trishvashrameshu konvartaha bhavet pramabhipsitaha. What use does it have for the other three ashramas now? Because, so, paramabhipsitaha, so when what is attained, what is desired is attained, what use does this wise person have for the other three ashramas? Iti.
Etena kramakrama sannyaso dhobe darshitau. Therefore, two ways of taking sannyasa, krama sannyasa, akrama sannyasa. What is krama sannyasa? In sequence, tadashuti. Brahmacharyam samapya gruhi bhavet gruhadvani bhutva pravrajet. So this is one. Brahmacharyam samapya gruhi bhavet. Having completed brahmacharya, one should take to life of gruhastashrama. Gruhadvani bhutva, from Grihastha Ashrama Vani Bhutva, take the Vanaprastha. Then pravrajet, then one should take the renunciation sannyasa. Yadiva itarsa, or otherwise also, brahmacharyadeva pravrajet, or if one is ready, one can renounce from brahmacharya itself, gruhadvar from Grihastha Ashrama, vanadvar from Vanaprastha Ashrama. Yadahareva virajet, tadahareva pravrajet. The day when one discovers vairagya, there is a day that one should renounce it. Comes from here itself. Brahadaranyaka. Tasmat adnyasya avirakta tadashayam karma anusthanam. Therefore, for an ignorant person, as long as vairagya is not there, the karma anusthanam must be there. Nishkama karma anusthanam must be there. Tasseva virakta dasha virakta tadashayam sanyasaha. And the same person. So, through performance of karma, when attain that tivra vairagya, then karma sannyasa. Shravanadi avasaradanena jnanartha iti. That sannyasa becomes means of knowledge, by giving him the occasion of the leisure to contemplate upon the self. Iti dashabhedena agnim adhikrityeva karma tatyago vyakhyatum. Panchama shastha dhyayav arabhyate dashabhedana. So same person is addressed here. In the beginning, karma anusthanam. For the same person, later on, karma tyaga. Yoga rudasya tasseva shamah karanam uchyate. Tasseva yoga. The same person who has become yoga rudha through performance karma, for that very same person, the karma tyaga is enjoined there. So this is how Madhusudan Saraswati also takes up the very same section and shows the connection, you know, of the Shruti and the Smruti and other statements. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.